So if you're wanting to find out more about how to increase testosterone naturally and testosterone booster foods, well, the good news is you have found the right video. We're gonna go through everything you need to know about testosterone in this week's video. So welcome to my channel. If you haven't been here before, we talk about everything medical and healthcare here on the channel. And the great news is, all of the information that we give on the channel is all evidence-based, so you know you can trust the information that we give you. And lastly, please remember, all of the information that we give on this video is all going to be timestamped in the description below. So if at any point you want to find any specific information, feel free to click on that description, click the relevant bit. But as I always say in every single video, make sure you watch the whole video because you're going to become a bit of an expert at the end of it. Lastly as well, I know I said lastly before, but lastly again, please don't forget, if you do find any of this information helpful, if you learned something new today, don't forget to click that like button because it's going to help me and it's going to help the video grow. Now let's begin. Okay, so first of all, let's go back to the basics. What is testosterone? Firstly, testosterone is not a chemical that causes fits of fury or, you know, illegally causes sports performance enhancement or anything like that. Testosterone is a hormone that we all create naturally, and it's actually made from cholesterol. Now, testosterone has many different functions in the body. For example, it can be responsible for muscle size, it can be responsible for having increasing strength, it can be responsible for increasing sex drive. So it has many different functions in the body. And last but not least, please remember that testosterone is not solely something that men have, women have it as well, and it's also really important for the ovarian cycle in women. Now, during puberty for men, testosterone does contribute towards the development of testes, the deepening of the voice, and also facial hair. However, although testosterone is seen as a sex hormone, there is new evidence now starting to appear that it can play a particular role in helping with our mood and our drive. So as you can see, if you have low levels of testosterone, it can cause problems such as reduced muscle mass. It can also cause your bones to become a lot more brittle, which means they're more likely to break. It can also reduce your sex drive, and it can cause loss of body hair as well. In men in particular, if you have lower levels of testosterone, it can cause, again, reduced sex drive, it can cause impotence, it can cause a lower sperm count. It can also cause gynecomastia, where the breast size increases in men. It can also sometimes cause female pattern hair loss. So these are the sort of things that are more particular to men, but as you can see, testosterone is a very important hormone that our body needs. Now, you may be thinking, well, what can be the cause for low testosterone? Well, in men in particular, after the age of 30, our testosterone levels start to reduce by about 2% every single year. So one of the main causes is a natural aging process that happens with all men. Another potential cause as well for men is something called male hypogonadism. And this is basically where the testes don't produce enough testosterone, so our testosterone levels go below the normal range. Now, this male hypogonadism can be caused by many different things. Genetics can play a big part in it. Diabetes, for example. Drug use, infections, so there's many different causes for it. Okay, so now that we've got a little background about testosterone and low testosterone levels and the importance of testosterone, now let's learn what we can do to naturally increase our testosterone, because there are many different things that you can do, and I hope you find it helpful, so let's begin. Okay, so let's start with tip number one. Tip number one is all about exercise. Look, we know that exercise can naturally boost our testosterone levels, and think about it. When you've gone to the gym, when you've gone for a run, when you've played a game of tennis, whatever you've done and you've finished it, you usually feel quite good afterwards. You feel pumped, you feel energetic, and this is usually due to the body releasing different neurotransmitters and hormones, and one of which is testosterone. We know from research that when you finished exercise, for at least 15 minutes to 1 hour, your testosterone levels are massively boosted. So we know that exercise is causing an increase in testosterone naturally. Now, some studies suggest that something called resistance training is one of the best ways to increase your testosterone levels. So this is activity where you make your muscles work against a weight or force. For example, weight bearing exercises using dumbbells or barbells or resistant bands, sandbags, squats and push-ups. All of these are known as resistance training. Now, other studies have shown that high intensity training can increase testosterone levels too. So this would include activities such as boot camp, circuits, running, aerobic classes, and I'll leave a full list in the description below for you. Now, please do bear in mind though that high intensity training, there is a bit of a mixed opinion on it in terms of research. So some research shows that it's good, but then other research shows that if you're doing endurance training long term, so if you're training for a marathon, let's say, or if you're running and you're doing like 5 miles 1 week and then increasing it to 10 miles, and then 15 miles, then 20 miles, so you're doing this high intensity training, can actually reduce your testosterone levels as well. So the evidence is kind of for and against it. So I guess the main thing to take home from it is, exercise to a normal amount. That's probably the best thing I can advise you. So exercise to a normal amount and don't do too much. Now moving on to tip number two, it's all about eating testosterone boosting foods that contain vitamin D, magnesium and zinc. All three of these have been shown in studies to increase your testosterone levels. Naturally, vitamin D in particular is really important for boosting our testosterone levels. Naturally, obviously please do remember that if you're thinking of making any major dietary changes, you should always speak to a healthcare professional. And if you are wondering how to have a healthy balanced diet, I do have a video on that topic already, which goes through it in loads of detail. So I'll leave a link up to it up here and in the description below for you. So the next question is, what are good sources of foods that you can get vitamin D, magnesium and zinc? And let's go through each one. Let's start with vitamin D. So in terms of vitamin D, you can find vitamin D in oily fish, probably the best source for it. Mushrooms are naturally fortified with them as well, with vitamin D as well. You can find them in eggs, but you need to make sure you're having the egg yolk, so the yellow bit. And also you can find it in red meat. However, it's important to remember as well that you will get it from your food, but it's also potentially a good idea to supplement with vitamin D, not just for testosterone, because vitamin D has been shown to help with loads of different things, from eczema to asthma. Everything is now getting linked to vitamin D. So I always recommend to my patients, take a vitamin D supplement, obviously if they're safe and suitable to take it. We can buy them over the counter from any chemist, any supermarket. And in terms of how many units or how many micrograms, I always recommend 1,000 units, which is equivalent to 25 micrograms. So that's the sort of vitamin D that I recommend. It's a low dose, but it's just, if you're taking it every day, it just keeps those levels in the normal range, which again, for testosterone, it's gonna help boost those levels. So what about magnesium? Well, magnesium is naturally found in things like pumpkin seed, spinach, black beans, the list goes on. But in general, most nuts, seeds and greeny leaf vegetables are high in magnesium, but I will leave more examples in the description below for you. And lastly, what about zinc? Well, zinc can be found naturally in most seafood, red meat and poultry, but vegetarian sources include beans, cereals and nuts. Okay, so moving on to tip number three. Tip number three is, are you living your best life? Are you living a healthy lifestyle? And I know that's a bit of a broad question, but I'm gonna ask you three simple questions now. Are you getting enough sleep? Are you chronically stressed? And are you drinking a lot of alcohol? Think about it, let's move on to the next bit. Okay, so let me give you a little bit of context behind those three questions. Let's begin with sleep. Look, it's believed that testosterone production is mainly during night whilst we're sleeping, okay? So you need to make sure that you're getting a correct amount of sleep. And studies have shown that getting as little as 5 hours of sleep can reduce your testosterone production by up to 15%, which is a massive amount. Now, in terms of how much sleep to get, I always recommend patients 8 hours of sleep per night, okay? If you're an adult, you should be getting a minimum of 8 hours of sleep per night. I don't go for 7, I always say 8, okay? The other important thing is having a good sleep cycle, having a good sleep routine. Look, for example, if you sleep at 10 and you're gonna get up at 7 or 6, okay, at least you're gonna get your 8 hours of sleep there, okay? And obviously, if you're gonna sleep at 10, it might take you half an hour to fall asleep, okay? So you need to make sure that you're calculating that you're getting your 8 hours of sleep. So you need a good routine and you need a good cycle. It's not good to be sleeping at different times every single night and trying to fit in 8 hours. You're not gonna get high quality sleep. And high quality sleep is one of the most important things for staying healthy. So if you do want more information on how to sleep better, how to have a better routine, how to have a good sleep cycle, I do have quite a few videos on them and I will leave links to them up here and in the description below, so feel free to check them out. Now, regularly drinking too much alcohol can also have an effect on testosterone. High alcohol intake has been shown to damage the testes, affect sperm production, hinder sexual performance, reduce testosterone, and can even eventually lead to infertility. So in short, excessive alcohol can be really bad, not just for testosterone levels, but everything male sex hormone related. So in terms of alcohol intake, to reduce that risk, you need to be making sure you're not having any more than 14 units per week. And that 14 units needs to be spread throughout the week, generally at least over 3 days. And you need to have alcohol-free days as well. So days that you're not having any alcohol whatsoever. Now, if it is difficult for you to calculate how many units you're having, I will leave a calculator in the description below. It's really helpful. And I do have a few videos as well on how to reduce the amount of alcohol your intake and strategies that are gonna help with it as well. So if you want more information on that, again, I'm gonna leave it up here and in the description below. And the final thing that I mentioned earlier as well about stress, I need you to really think about how stressful your life is and what you do in your life that might be causing you stress. High levels of stress do reduce our testosterone levels naturally. So we need to do something about it. There are many different stress busting techniques available out there. And again, I feel like I'm plugging all my videos in this week's video, but I do have really helpful videos on this topic as well when it comes comes to stress, I have some great videos looking at different techniques that are really gonna help relax you, okay? And when to seek medical advice about it as well, because that's important as well. Sometimes we take all the stress in and we're not letting it out, and especially as men as well, we don't like to talk about these kinds of things or our mental health, and we need to make it more normal to speak about these sort of things. So please do check out those videos if you do feel like you are someone who's stressing a lot. So I will leave a link to it up here and in the description below. Okay, so how are we getting on so far? I really hope that you're finding this information helpful, and if you found any of it new or helpful so far, please do not forget to click that like button. Like I said, it's gonna help me, it's gonna make me happy to look at it, and it's also gonna help the video grow to a larger audience so more and more people can see it and learn from it. So the next thing I wanted to move on to is, we've spoken about things that can naturally increase our testosterone, but unfortunately, I've noticed that there's a lot of misinformation out there about what can help increase our testosterone levels. So I just thought we'd bust a few myths now. So the first myth I wanna talk about is having a cold shower. Apparently, this is the greatest thing to increase your testosterone levels, but the bad news is that, well, it's actually good news probably, because I hate a cold shower. I really can't tolerate cold water hitting my skin, but maybe some people like it. But the good news is that cold showers have no effect on testosterone levels. There's no studies that show that cold showers increase your testosterone levels. So if you are currently having cold showers every day of the week, please stop it, because you're actually getting no benefit from it, and I can imagine it's quite unpleasant. And in fact, some studies have actually shown that putting your body through extreme cold temperatures can actually reduce our testosterone levels. So not only are we busting myths now, we're actually fixing these myths that are actually causing the problem in the first place. So if you do take a cold shower, scrap it. Now, another myth that I've seen a lot of people speaking about, especially in comment sections and people ask me about, is having steak and eggs every single day. Unfortunately, again, we've spoke about vitamin D, magnesium, and zinc, and these do help testosterone production. But you need to remember, in life and the human body, we need to take everything in moderation. So everything in normal amounts. If you're having steak and egg every single day, it's gonna cause other types of problems, okay? We need a normal amount of these nutrients and minerals and vitamins and vitamin D and everything like that. It just needs to be a normal amount. We don't need to be excessive about it. So please don't have steak and egg every single day. It's just gonna cause loads of other problems. For example, one thing that just comes to mind straight away is massive amounts of cholesterol, and it's gonna increase the LDL, and it's gonna cause loads of different problems for you down the line, potential cardiovascular disease and strokes and heart disease and all these sort of problems. So everything needs to be in moderation. So if you do want more information, like I said, on a healthy balanced diet, I did link it up here, and I'm gonna leave it in the description below as well. But definitely don't be having steak and eggs every single day. Just a normal amount is perfectly fine. Now, there are also some theories to eat a diet very high in fat, which is gonna help with testosterone production. Again, this is incorrect. There's no real evidence supporting it. This is taken from a study looking at men who are having a low fat diet who then have low testosterone levels. But these studies were done on athletes. And if you remember, when we looked at endurance athletes, we spoke about studies that actually that's actually causing low testosterone levels. So for normal people, it doesn't mean that if you're having a low-fat diet, it's gonna cause low testosterone levels. There were other factors involved in this that caused the low testosterone in this study. So please remember, have a normal diet, a healthy, balanced diet. You don't need to be having a massively high fat intake diet. All it's gonna do is cause problems down the line. And that's one of the most important things I wanna keep saying in this video. Everything needs to be in moderation. If you're not doing things in moderation, it's just gonna cause problems later down the line. And the thing about these problems is they take time to eventually show up. It's not gonna happen straight away, but eventually it will show up, and then you'll kind of regret doing it in the first place. Now, it's also important to note that eating a diet very high in fat can lead to obesity, and this can lead to the opposite effect, as it has been linked to lower levels of testosterone. So, although there is some evidence that a diet high in fat can increase testosterone, instead it's better to do it part of a balanced, healthy diet that doesn't lead to obesity. And when choosing those high fat foods, try to opt for healthy fats such as avocado, oily fish, and nuts, like we spoke about earlier. Now, when it comes to seeking medical attention, I really do hope that everyone watching this video has already spoke to their healthcare professional. And if they do have lower testosterone levels, they're watching this video to see what they can do to naturally help with that. However, please remember, if you do think for any reason you have low testosterone levels, you should always speak to your healthcare professional. Do not make that diagnosis on your own. Please do not do that. They need to do a blood test. You need to speak to your healthcare professionals. You need to take a history. You need to find out exactly what the symptoms are. Like I said, the blood test is needed to find out if your testosterone levels are low. Generally speaking as well, the blood tests are done in the morning. because that's when our testosterone levels are at its highest. That's the peak, basically. Now, just again, please remember, don't just go off, you know, the symptoms that you've read through Google and thinking that, oh yeah, I've got low testosterone, because low testosterone levels, the symptoms are very similar to other things as well. So please do not self-diagnose. And if you think you do have low testosterone levels, always speak to your healthcare professional. That is the most important thing, because your health is the most important thing. Okay, so I guess we've come to the end of this week's video. You now are a bit of a testosterone pro. You now know all about the hormone. You know what it does. You now know how it's made. You now know about all the different things that you can do to naturally increase your testosterone and testosterone boosted foods and when to seek medical attention. You know everything. You're a bit of a testosterone pro. So tell your friends, tell your family, tell your loved ones. And I really do hope you find this information helpful. And if you've got any of your own tips as well, please leave a comment below, because I know I'd love to read it, and I'm sure everyone watching this video would too. As I always say at the end of every single week's video, always remember you're awesome, and I will see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.